I don't need to apologize for who I am. I don't need to apologize for what I do.
How are you today?
I'm good, and yourself?
Good. How was your Thanksgiving?
Oh, it was too good. I really enjoyed myself this Thanksgiving. I think that kind of says a lot right there.
I think it's fully understood from what you say from that. That's awesome. Okay, so before we chat about your new single On Top of the World, let's chat about your ANTM All-Star experience. So, first of all, it sucks you were booted. I'm totally rooting for you.
Aw, thank you.
So do you think that you were eliminated because Express and Extra couldn't handle all the pretty that the fabulous Dominique serves?
You know what? I honestly think it just wasn't meant to be, and, you know, this is obviously not a part of my story, and I think it's a part of, you know, I'm not sure whose story is going to be a part of, but, you know, the girls that are left, I wish them all the best of luck, and it's going to be a part of one of their stories, and that's okay with me. When one door closes, another one opens, and for me, honestly, I just look at it, you know, it wasn't meant to be, so now that this is over with, what am I going to do next?
Definitely. Admittedly, I wasn't your biggest fan during cycle 10, but this cycle, you honestly, it was like night and day. What do you think was the difference? Was it editing, or you just grew, you know, your mother now, etc.? What do you think the reason is?
You know, some of it could be contributed to editing, but at the same time, you know, I've improved a lot. You know, after cycle 10, I got to work. I took in all the feedback that the judges gave me for cycle 10, and I made it work for me and not against me. One thing that is the same from cycle 10 to Modelville to now here, the All-Star cycle, is that I'm that girl that's open to taking in feedback. I'm the girl that keeps improving and wants to get better. And I have the same positive attitude that I had cycle 10 this time around.
So is that why you decided to come back? Just sort of a kind of a redemption edit, for lack of a better phrase?
A redemption edit. I think every time I have an opportunity to work with Miss Tyra Banks, I jump on it. She's taught me so much. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be right here where I'm at right now at this point in time in my career. It's because of her that I've been able to grow and get better. You know what I'm saying? Like, so to me, when she called me again this time around, I said, you know what, this is another opportunity for my fans to see me, see how much growth I've had, and to see me in a different light. And, you know, I'm going to take this, and I'm going to run with it. And I sure did.
You did a 100-meter dash for that, girl.
Right.
So I've read a few interviews from a few of the previous girls who have been eliminated, and a few of them have said that it wasn't what they expected, this All-Star cycle. Was it what you expected? Was it everything that it was promised to you?
I mean, come on now. Being on national television, on a reality TV show that is Tyra Banks' reality TV show, might I say,
yeah.
You don't know what to expect. So to walk into a competition saying, well, I expected this, I mean, come on now. I mean, I walked into this competition saying, you know, here's an opportunity for me to challenge myself. And I used every photo shoot, every challenge to challenge myself to get better. I looked at it as an opportunity for me to grow and for millions of people and possible clients to see what I do, regardless of what the judges say, to see what I do on national television. It's free exposure. Why not?
I know, right? Exactly.
Right. So I didn't look at it like that. And then, you know, I guess, you know, I have a very positive attitude towards everything. So going into panel, you know, I figured, hey, I have Andre Leon Talley, and I have Tyra Banks and Nigel Barker and whoever our guest celebrity judge is talking about me. And I bet millions of girls want to be in my shoes right now. So thank you very much.
Definitely. Before the music video challenge, had you ever entertained of becoming a pop star?
You know what? Growing up... You're gonna laugh. I thought I was a mix between Tyra Banks and Mariah Carey, and nobody could tell me anything. Like Mariah in her early days, and Tyra in her early days. I used to watch E Television back when they had when it was more of a fashion network, and they had a lot of those fashion shows running. And mm-hmm. I fell in love with all the fashion shows, and at one moment I wanted to be Tyra, and then I turned a channel and I'm like, oh, Mariah Carey, oh yeah. And I'd have my brothers record me with a camcorder, you know, just doing my thing. But as I got older, you know, I kind of steered away from that. I focused just on the modeling, and I got really shy when it came to my music. So this to me was an opportunity to challenge myself, because I've always wanted to go into music, and Tyra just said, hey, if you want to do it, here's your opportunity. You better take it and run with it, girl.
No, I have to admit, you had actually probably the best voice out of all, and I was surprised. And the next day when your music video debuted after that episode aired, I'm like, man, I'm glad she did it, because you actually do have potential. I love it.
Thank you so much. And that's the same thing she told me. She said, you know, run with this. You know, I think this could be really good for you. She gave me a lot of great advice. And if it wasn't for doing the music video on the show, who knows? On Top of the World might not be here.
It was Derek Blanks who directed it, correct?
That's correct.
Right. I know the first time I ever heard of him was on an episode of Real Housewives of Atlanta. Do you ever watch that show?
Yes.
Is that how you met
Another guilty or? Pleasure.
So how did the single come about? Did you write it? Who produced it? I couldn't really find it. Who produced it?
It was produced by a guy named Jesse Cow.
Okay.
His producer name is actually Nick Swagger.
Okay.
And it's MC Swagger. And he is amazing. He produced the track. We wrote the track together. We had just a lot of fun on this track.
So do you plan on making any other singles in the near future, or like, and releasing an album, kind of like your ANTM alum, Lisa?
I am working on my album right now. This week, I go back to, I go to Atlanta, and we're having a music video premiere in Atlanta for my next music video that I shot with Derek Blanks.
Oh.
It's called Main Chick, and I have a pretty well-known rapper rapping on the track with me. Her name is Diamond.
Okay, yeah.
And it's the next single.
And when can we see that?
Out. Hopefully within the next month.
Okay.
Very excited about this song and this video. It's a little different than On Top of the World, but at the same time, I think when you see the video and you hear the song, you're going to be like, okay, I didn't expect this, and that's exactly what I wanted. The next video has more of a rock pop,
okay.
Maybe a little bit of R&B feel to it, but more rock and pop feel to it, and it's a different type of song.
Do you plan on releasing a full length single of Booty Tooch or a remake of it on it, just to pay homage to your ATM days?
You know what? I think I am going to.
Okay.
I wasn't planning on going back and revisiting that song, but so many people have asked me, Dominique, do a remix to Booty Tooch. We love that song.
I really should. I really
do. Actually, to be honest with you, that song, I named it Stop and Stare. It wasn't actually, Tyra named it Booty Tooch.
Okay. A general sort of comment for those naysayers who just will lump you into another reality star releasing another album. How do you stand out in a sea of reality stars releasing novelty singles?
You know what? I look at this. It's kind of difficult because I know that, you know, there's the girl that was on Housewives of Atlanta. She released
you
a single.
Party for your party.
Party for the party. Oh, my God. And, you know, people talked about that song and, oh, it's horrible and this and this and this. But I'm sorry, I've heard it, like, in the club a gazillion times. And that song, I've actually heard it quite a bit. And whether you love to hate us or hate to love us, I'm glad I have a fan base. Thank you for being a fan,
definitely.
So I embrace all the feedback, positive and good, and a lot of the people, you know, especially on America's Next Top Model, a lot of the girls coming into this competition have other talents. You know, Top Model was kind of my segue into this industry, into opening up doors, into doing different things. I've always looked up to Tyra, and Tyra's done, you know, modeling. She's done acting. She's done singing. She's done all three, and then some.
So before closing, let's just cover a couple quick questions about ATM All-Star Cycle, because I know our fans really want to know about that. So who were you shocked was in the competition that you were most shocked
at? Who was
at?
I shocked?
Yeah.
You know, I can't really say I was shocked about anybody being actually in the competition. I thought going into the competition that I was going to see Jade Bear.
Oh, Jade.
I thought I was going to see Kara.
Yeah. You mean the biracial butterfly, right?
Yes, I thought I was going to see Jade. I thought I was going to see Takara. But at the same time, I wasn't sure what to expect.
Right.
And I know with Tyra, expect the unexpected. But at the same time, I did expect to see Shannon, and I was excited and thrilled about meeting Shannon because she was on the very first cycle of America's Next Top Model. She is the OG of Top Model,
and if
it wasn't for her show having good ratings, you know, Cycle 10 would have never gotten here.
Exactly.
So I was excited to meet Shannon. I was excited to meet Lisa and Brittany, for that matter. Oh, my gosh, personality. Oh, my good Lord.
One last ATM question. When you were eliminated, what did you do in Crete? Did you get to hang out? Did you go party? Did you, like, lie on the beach?
I'm not exactly sure if I'm allowed to answer that, but
okay,
I will say this. I will say this. I enjoyed, oh my gosh, they had this chocolate mousse. Oh, after I got eliminated, I went and indulged.
Well, of course, you didn't have to pose in lingerie and Greek salad anymore, of course.
Oh, I'm sorry. You can never have enough of Greek salad there.
So, in closing, do you have any last words to your fans and what they can expect for you in the next coming months or in 2012?
So, I have my single coming out, Main Chick, that will be dropping very soon, within the next month. And the music video that I shot with Derek Blanks, that should be coming out in the next month, and it's featuring a well-known rapper named Diamond. I also am working on my album. I also plan on doing some international travels in the future, because I've had the fans overseas have just showed me so much love, and I really want to show them that same love back and reach out and say, hey, you can see me, you can talk to me, you can touch me. So I plan on doing some international travels in the future, you know, Philippines, the UK. We don't have any exact dates and whereabouts just yet, but I will be traveling internationally to see my fans overseas too as well.
Oh my gosh, I completely forgot to ask one question. Our writer who does all the recaps for all the ATM episodes wanted me to ask you, so how did it feel being compared to a drag queen? Did that, like, hurt your feelings, or was that...
Oh, my gosh, yeah. That was, like, the biggest compliment in the whole entire world.
Okay.
Are you serious? First of all, the whole tranny thing, I embrace that, honey, okay? First of all, trannies, they do it better than we do.
This is true.
If you don't even know it, when you see a tranny, a good one, a real one, you're not even sure if that is... You don't know. You think that's a woman. So, to me, when they called me a tranny, I said, oh, thank you. I'm soaking all of that...
It's good that you feel that way. That's awesome. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for taking the time with us. I definitely appreciate it. And honestly, wish you all the best in your futures. And we'll definitely be keeping touch of your career and following you.
That would be great. Thank you, Donovan. I appreciate it. You were great to talk to.
Thanks, Dominique. Appreciate it, too.